Okay, so good morning all, and welcome to another lecture of 8085 programming, in which we have almost studied around 16 to 17 programs, and today we are going to learn how to count the number of ones in a given word. What it implies is we have a 16 bit number, and in that how many number of ones appear, that is what we need to count over, right? So this is the simplest program that we can do. So let us start with that. Let me share my screen, and what are the things which are related to that, we'll talk on that first, and then we'll shift it to the program, right? So we'll try to solve it in a less time. Let me introduce myself. Dr. Nilesh Veshram, and I'm head and associate professor of Sri Mathuradas Mota College of Science, Department of Electronics. And today we are going to study this program, which is actually a 16 bit number is stored in a register pair HL, and we have to write an assembly language program to count the number of ones in a given word and display the count. Now this display the count has itself a different program, so it is a very small program that can be written in the main program, right? So that is what is to be done later, but we'll start to store that. So this is what is a program, this is a problem. Now the things which we need in this are the subroutine and subroutine handling. This is what we have studied earlier. What do you understand by a subroutine? It is a special program which is written outside the main program, and in the main program we are supposed to call that subroutine. That's we call that small program many times if we require. So the number of lines which might have increased due to this consecutive writing of the same program can be reduced in this. So we are going to use this concept of subroutine over there. And this is the basic concept of subroutine that we have talked earlier also on this. So subroutine is nothing but a small program which is written outside the main program. And in the main program, we are supposed to call the subroutine. And you require that many times you can call this subroutine. So this is the first instruction, and at the end we are having the return instruction so that it returns back to the main program again, and it executes another series of instructions, and then again we can call that subroutine, and it will land the first instruction, and again it will return to the next program. So this is how the subroutine works. This is we already have studied the concepts of subroutine, I guess, in our early classes. So return is the main program, and this is how the subroutine works if we are going to call. So yeah, if we need to call this, so automatically it will land over there. So 400 may call karna hai whenever we are just writing that. So it is that we have already done through this. Now the logical instructions that we are expecting to use over here, we are not going to use this. But I guess, yes, RAL instruction we are going to use. We might use any of these two. RAL, each binary bit of accumulator is rotated left by one position through the carry flag. So you can use this instruction also. You can use RLC also, right? Accordingly, whatever you expect. So this, the carry flag is set or reset according to the condition of the last bit, the most significant bit. RAL instruction, this is how it works. So it rotates through left, yes, 1001. This is shifted toward, and this is given to the first carry, right? And accordingly, it goes on shifting as we go on using this rotate accumulator left to carry. So RAL is there. Then similarly, we are having another instruction that is RAR. Now here, this is the shift is towards the right. So we can move the contents of the accumulator to right by one position through the carry. Same as RAL. So we are supposed to use these two, any of these two instructions. So yes, RAR is going to move to the right hand side. Similarly, RRC, right? So we can use any of the instructions. These are circular left shift to carry, right? Circular left shift, RRC. These all can be used. Is rotated to by right by one position and D0 in the position of D7 as well as in the carry. So this can also be used carry is modified according to D0, right? So all the flags sign 0 parity and auxiliary carry are not affected by this. Only carry flag is being affected by this, right? So we are going to use that particular. So now let us start the program. So the concept that we are going to use is by using the rotate instruction, we need to check the carry. So let us start the program. So the program, we have taken these two numbers, H and L in register pair. HL, we are supposed to store this number. So in H, we are going to store 56. L, we are going to store 70F. And when we say to count the number of ones, what it actually implies is this H consists of 56. In binary, it is like this. So 0101 and 6 is 0110, right? So to count how many times this one up is appearing. So in this, I guess the number of ones over here are 4. So I am writing here 4. Similarly, in when we talk in terms of L, and in L we are having 7F. So 7 in binary is 0111. And F in binary is 1111, right? So number of ones in this byte is actually 4 plus 3, that is 7. So number of ones are 7. So the total number of ones in this count can be written, can be stored in register C, and that is equivalent to 11 of decimals. And in hexadecimal, we call it as 0B. Right. So this is the answer we are expecting in this program. So let us start the program. I guess you have understood the logic of it and you might try it at your own. Let us analyze this program. So for analyzing, getting the number of which number of ones is to be counted, that is to be taken in the accumulator. Now rotating through the carry and check the carry. Right. So this is the concept that we need to use. And this is the logic, by rotating through the carry, check the carry, right? So store the result in register C, same as it is. So H is having 56, 0101, 0110, and number of ones are 4. Similarly for L, 77F, so the number of ones over there are 07, and the total number of ones are supposed to be 0B, that is in hexadecimal. So let us start the program. So we are going to write this in two parts. So we are going to use one subroutine and the other one is the main program. So the main program will be a very smaller one, but we are going to call the subroutine two times over there. So what is the basic concept of it? Just remember this. So the first we will load the register pair HL. If you, I expect from your side, because you need to answer those questions, what type of instruction that we are going to use. So just remember this. What we are going to do, we are going to load the HL pair with the number. Then we are going to put the, we are going to specify some of the registers to store the count, right? And then we'll move L or H in register A. Then we'll rotate the accumulator 8 times. We repeat that, that we'll do in the subroutine, right? And then we'll return back. And again, we'll move the H pair and again we'll call H register in accumulator and then we'll call the subroutine again and we'll store the result, right? So this is the basic concept. Now let us start with the main program, right? So the main program will be written in the same form. I guess my screen is visible to you all. Is it visible? And you are able to see the table and how yes, we are going to write the program, right? Thank you. So yeah, so we'll start with this program. So the first memory location where we are going to write. Now this is a subroutine, right? So we are supposed to write this as a subroutine. So can you tell me what would be the first instruction? Subroutine. We are writing a subroutine, right? So in the subroutine, what we are expecting to write? Yeah, we are going to write the number of times we have to rotate. So we are moving the accumulator through right or left, anyway, all around. 8 times, so that all the bits get circulated around, right? So we are moving the counter. So NVIB, then the opcode is 0608, right? Then we'll rotate the accumulator through carry to left. So that is written over here, that is 07 is the instruction. We'll check that. Then rotate this, and at 6303, what we'll do? We will check the carry. Jump if not carry. If it is carry, then store. If it is not carry, then jump to the next instruction. Right? So jump to jump if not carry. Next, we'll write the say the memory location. Later, when we'll write next. So at 6301, if there is a carry, then it is going to increment register C. We are supposed to store the count in register C, right? So increment C, then 86 opcode of increment C. I will check that and store the carry. Then what we'll do? We'll decrement the count DCR. So this is where we are expecting to jump next. So 0863. Then DCRB, right? Decrement the register B, count of register. Then if it is not zero, again jump back to RLC. So it is actually in the reverse direction. So reverse, we are having the opcode as 0263. I guess that will come afterwards. Yeah. And then return. So this will count the number of ones in the particular byte that is in the accumulator. So this is a subroutine that we need to write. So return to the main program. I guess So this is a jump where we need to jump is at RLC. So RLC AI is just going to jump. So this reverse can be written over here, right? So this is actually a subroutine, and in the main program we are supposed to call that, right? Let us start with the main program. So again, to analyze, it's a simple one. We have to take that number in the accumulator and then moving, rotating it and calling the, this is a simple program. Main program is very simple. We are moving the data and we are moving the content in accumulator, and then we are rotating. Then we are directly calling the subroutine and storing the result, right? This is the program logic I already told you. Now let us start with the main program. So this is a main program. Again, we need to write it in the same fashion: memory location, label, mnemonics, opcode, and remarks. Now this is what we are going to start at 6200. So the first instruction would be, what would be the first instruction in the main program? What would be?
LXIH.
Yeah, definitely. LXIH what? Can you tell me the number? Yeah, we have taken that. So LXIH567F, right? This is a 16-bit number. We call it as a word, right? 2 bytes means one word. So we are having this 2-byte number, and we have to store in HL pair. So we have loaded the 21567F. So this is a full word, but in accumulator, we can store only 8-bit at a time or 1-byte at a time. So we'll be moving 1-byte. So we have loaded this HL pair by this number, of which we need to count the number of ones. And in the next instruction, what we'll do, we'll empty the register C to store the counts, how many times the C number of ones is there. So we are moving 00 in register C. The opcode is 0E00. We can check this to store the count. Yeah, we have emptied register C for that. And the next is, now we will move the first number. So what would we move? Move the content of register L into the accumulator. So we are taking the contents of register L first, might be 7F. So it is being moved in the accumulator, and that is the first byte. I guess we'll have to check this opcode. So 70, that is the first byte. Now what we need to do is, we need to just call the subroutine. So we are going to call the subroutine. 6300 is the subroutine. So we have called it. The opcode is CD0063, right? So we have called the subroutine. It will do our work. It will count the number of ones in the first byte that is supposed to be in register L, right? Okay, one job is done. So what is the next job now? To move the content of register H. So we are moving it. Now the content of register H is moved in accumulator over here. Again, now this is that. Second byte is moved in register A. Now we will, what we'll do? Oh, yes. We are going to call the, okay. We have missed that, I guess. So we have to call the subroutine again. So yes, what we'll do, we'll just copy paste this. Yeah, so we'll copy paste this over here so that it will appear. Yeah, this is what I always, okay, that's why I require so many time to do this, because it requires a lot of, yeah, so it's done, I guess, and now we'll move this. Okay, it's not coming again. Yes, it's gone wrong. Yeah, now it's coming. So I will be putting this, and we will be putting this after 18, 19, 20, 21. Yes. So I guess it works now. Yeah, this is the first number that we have stored, and we have moved the register C to store the count. Now we have called this subroutine for to measure the number of counts in register L. Now we have moved the contents of register H in accumulator again. Now the memory location is going to change. We will call it again 6300, showing you. So it will again call the subroutine for the second byte, and then it will end. So that will be called, right? So we need to check the memory locations also in that. So this is how, this is a very simple program where we need to check the number of ones in a word, right? So shall we do that? I guess it's understood, I guess. If you have any issues, you can ask me the question. So do you have any problems? So shall we go for to execute this? Let us start to execute. I guess this is 6200, 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06, 07, 08, 09, 0A, 0B, 0C, and this must come at 0D. Yes. So this is for the main program, and this is for the subroutine that we are having. Right? So can we perform this? I guess my screen is not visible to you. Achha, it is visible. Yes. So this is the subroutine that we are expecting to run, and then we we need to check. This is a subroutine, and we are going to call it in the main program, and this is supposed to be the main program. So this is the main program that we are expecting. Here there is no label. It's written over there back, but it is not of any use. So it is not in the main program. So we have just done that. So I guess this is okay for today. So let us start, or let us try it on a mobile phone, whether it works or not. So shall I do that? Yeah. Can we do that? Anybody can reply? Yes, so let us try.
Yes, sir. Yes.
We are going to do that. Let me know. Yes. Yes. I'm expecting that I should get the output. Yeah. So let us start with this. So I will start with our app. That is this one. It's running over there. So shall we start? We'll start the main program at 6200. So substitute memory 6200. Next, I guess it's visible to you. Let us start. Can somebody tell me 21, next 56, next 7F, yes, then next 0E, next 00, this is for to store the count, then we have 7D, is 7D okay? That is move L to A, first byte, then CD means call the program subroutine, that is 0063. Yes. Then Next is 7C. 7C. Next, CD. Next, 00. Next, 63. Yes, and the last one is 76. Yeah. So the main program is done. Reset, substitute memory 6300. So we are going to write the subroutine. Yeah. So where is the subroutine? Yeah. So it is at 6300. First instruction is MVIB. So we'll write 06. Next 08. That is the count that many times it has to rotate. Then RLC, that is 07. Rotate through left. Rotate accumulator through left. Then D2. Jump if not carry. JNC. 08. At this memory location, I guess. 08. Yeah. 63. 63. Now one job is over. Increment if there is a carry, that is 86. Yeah. Then decrement the count, that is 05. So I guess this much 6300, 01, 02, 03, 04, 05. 03, 04, 05, and this must be 06. Yeah, 06. Then we are having this at 07. Right. 07, it is 05. Then jump if not 0, that is C2. Next, jump to the RLC instruction, that is 0263. Yeah, so 0 is over there. C2, 07, 08, 09, 08. Yes, and then last is return. That will come at 0B. 0B. Next, C9. Yes. So I guess we have written the subroutine. So this is done. Now reset. Now we have to run the main program. Yeah. I guess Modgare was ready. Prashik. Right. So now check. So reset, go 6200, execute. Yeah, it has been executed. Now let us check. Reset, exam register, register C. Oh my God, it's showing you 00. So I guess something is wrong over there. Let us check what is the drawback. So just hold it for a second.
Excuse me.
Yeah. So I will end this. Kindly go through the program, and if there are any queries, so let me know. So thank you. Thank you very much. We'll continue this in the next class, I guess. So hopefully you have understood what we have done. We just need to count the number of ones in a word. And that is what we were expecting, and we have tried it. But it is showing them discrepancies. So we might do it in the next class. So thank you. Stay. Have a nice time. Stay home. Stay safe. And take care. Good day. See you soon in the next class. Day after tomorrow on Monday. Bye.